listen to the program all the time. E-E-C-H. Yeah. Best radio program. I gotta go now. It's time for Dr. For the goodbye.
Hello, Igor.
Hello, Dr. Pitt. What have you brought today?
Well, today I want to show you some guinea pigs.
Guinea pigs.
They have another name, too. They can also be called a cabbie. Come on, little fella.
Squeak, squeak.
All right. Now, Dr. Petvet is here, and everything is fine. Now, isn't he cute? Just take a look at that.
Oh,
isn't that
beautiful.
Something?
Beautiful.
Oh, he is beautiful. He's...
What's his name?
Well, I call this one Gus, and the other is Gilda.
Gus and Gilda.
That's absolutely right. Oh, now, they're larger and slower than a hamster, but they're timid and oh, so... Cuddly, I just think they're wonderful. They have a beautiful disposition. They're just so lovely. They're very clean, but they're slow to learn tricks. But that doesn't matter. They're still wonderful pets, and I just love them. Now, it squeaks when it wants attention, you see. It has delicate health, and it must be kept clean, because they really like to be kept clean. Now, their lifespan is 7 years, which is pretty good for these little animals, you see. Now, they're closely related, strangely enough, to the porcupine. Now, their name comes from guinea. Now, that is the amount of money that it originally costs. You see, a guinea is 21 shillings.
That's right.
And that's a guinea, and they call it a pig, although not related to the pig. But do you hear that little squeal that keeps coming out with all the time?
Just like a piggy.
That's right. This little piggy went to market. This little guinea stayed home.
That one stayed home. This one came out.
Exactly. Oh, isn't he cute?
Lovely.
I just love him. Now, they have very small litters, only two or three at a time, you see. Mm-hmm. And they're various colors. There's white, black, and brown, with, just many variations. You know, we can't, Gilda's kind of sleeping in there, but she's three different colors all at once. They're black, white, and brown there. Yes. Oh, they're just so, and they have three distinct lengths of hair. Now, the longest is so long that you can't tell which end is which. It's really wonderful. Now, one of the first animals to be tamed. Now, some were found in tombs or Egyptian pharaohs. Now, they don't bite, and they get to a length of up to 10 inches. So they keep them in a wire cage. Now, their diet is, lots of vitamins, C, green vegetables, and things like that. And I want you, Igor, to have Gus and Gilda
for
your very
me.
Own. For your very own, yes. Why don't you check with the sloth and see how
I
we stand
teach
today.
Them tricks.
All right, Gus, I'm going to put you back inside now. There's the
Mr. Sloth! I'm sorry, I didn't mean to wake you up, but I got a couple friends, Gus and Gilda.
That's right.
And I want them to... You don't want them to. You can have a couple minutes to think it over. Thank you very much.
Well,
he talked it over.
Yes, I can see
and the
that.
Answer is goodbye, Gus and Gilda.
Well, don't worry.
And come and see us again.
We'll come back. And remember what my button says. Pets are friends. Right.
Goodbye, Dr. Pettit. Come again soon.